going to do my very first video diary. I hope that you guys enjoy this series. It's kind of just like me telling stories of my past. This one is a question that I've been getting so much. So it is, why do I have towels over my windows in my room tour video? This all started when I was pretty young, I'd say around 12 years old. The first time this happened, I didn't think anything of it, but I was 12 years old and I was playing with my friends outside. I don't remember what we were doing, but I just got a really, really bad headache. Not your average headache, just like a little bit worse than your average headache. I was like, oh my God, like I can't, it's really painful. I need to go inside. So I went inside and I lied down and I was just like, oh my gosh, this is so painful. It's like, I was just sort of like squinting my eyes saying like, oh, I have a really bad headache, you know? And my mom, I didn't take Tylenol or anything. Back then I didn't like to take pills. I don't like to take anything foreign into my body. You know, I don't even drink. I don't smoke. I don't do drugs. I don't do anything like that. Just still to this day, because I don't like foreign things being put in my system. I think that if I just, you know, rest or, you know, put my head down, then my headache can go away naturally. I really like that. So even at 12 years old, that's how my mindset was. So I was just lying there waiting for my headache to go away, and eventually it did. It was just sort of like a weird, worse than your average headache. From then, I wish I had those from that when I was 12 years old. They now progressively kept getting worse every single time I got them. Back then, I would get one probably like once a month. So the next time I got one, it was a little bit worse. The next time it was worse than that, just like a little bit, not like dramatically. And when I was about, I'd say about a year and a half later, 13 and a half, that's when they started getting really bad. I always just say now that I'm getting a migraine, even though a typical migraine is like half the intensity of what mine are. So if you have a migraine, you know, experience lots of pain, but mine are double that. I've also seen a neurologist, which I'll talk with in a little bit, but mine are worse than your average migraine. So this time I didn't know this, right? I was only 13, I don't know. But this is what would happen. It could happen any time in the day. It was usually in the morning when I woke up, about an hour after I woke up. That's when they usually happen, but sometimes they happened at night in the middle of the day, but it was usually in the morning. And I would first see, usually in this eye, sometimes in this eye, a blind spot. Like it was about this big, right? And even if I looked around, that blind spot would follow me. I couldn't get it out of my eye, and it was blind. It was just a white circle. And sometimes there were like weird little shapes, you know, like that. But that's how it was in my eye, blind, white circle, and I couldn't see out of it. When I was writing, you know, obviously I'm in school, I'm writing, I couldn't see that the page on that circle. I could see out of this eye. I couldn't see through that circle. Like I was legit blind. And that, first of all, got me very worried. That's how my migraines are to this day. They're a lot worse, but I will get into that. But also, that it's just blind. Like I couldn't see just out of that little spot, though. Like I could see out of this eye and stuff. And that blind spot usually lasted about 20 minutes. The blind spot usually lasts about 20 minutes, and then I'm fine for about 10 minutes, you know. No blind spot, no pain whatsoever. I'm fine. I'm just fine. And then I get hit with the migraine, is what I call it. Even though it's worse than a migraine, I still call it the migraine, where it's excruciating pain. I do not want people to tell me, oh yeah, I have migraines too and they're painful. You do not have my migraines. You have no idea. But a lot of people tell me, oh yeah, I get migraines all the time. Like, I've went to the neurologist. He's told me these things. Like, he's seen migraines. He's seen people with migraines. Mine are so much worse and severe and life-threatening than most people. So having said that, because I know there's going to be people saying, oh, I have the same ones. Like, yes, I know people have migraines, but not mine. So then I would get the excruciating migraine where I would have to go home. And I can barely open my eyes. It's painful, and I'm just like lying there in pain. And you know, that's the point when they would get really bad like that. I would be like, you know, I need to take a Tylenol, I need to take something because this is so painful. And it wouldn't help at all. Like, a Tylenol doesn't do anything. Like, it, nothing, kind of makes it worse just because it's so severe. Migraine, Tylenol, liquid gels, all of that, head on, nothing ever works even an inch, nothing. So I basically have to pain it out, and the migraine usually lasts a total of about 5 hours. I know it sounds severe, but that's how long it lasts, and it is severe, severe, severe to the point where I throw up because I am in so much pain. My body can't take the pain. It's so much pain that my body throws up, and I just like I'm dying on the bathroom floor, like puking. My so much pain. It's everywhere on my head, but it's mainly the most right here behind my eyes, back on my neck right here, and my shoulders. It's everywhere. Once I throw up, it's actually kind of at least better. It kind of relieves it because I think it's like the strain of me throwing up kind of like relieves it a bit, and I can actually sleep for maybe half an hour, and then I will get up in excruciating pain. I don't like throwing up at all. I hate it. After about 5 hours, it's gone, completely gone, and I, you know, kind of have like a little tiny headache left, just like sort of sensitive, but nothing severe at all. Like, it's all good. And they progressively started getting worse, and when I was 14, that's when they were getting really bad. I would get one probably like once a month, and I didn't know why. Like, why am I getting these? Like, then I went to the neurologist, and he was like, okay, I've seen migraines before, I know all this. And then they did a CAT scan, I think it was called, on my brain. They, you know, they looked at my brain. Then they, you know, saw that I had a normal brain. I had some signs of trauma. He told me a 14-year-old shouldn't have these signs of, what did he say? A brain aneurysm. He said I was having signs of a brain aneurysm. Like I had a brain aneurysm. Well, I didn't have brain aneurysm, but minimal signs to having a brain aneurysm. That was so shocking for me and my dad. Like, I basically have a brain aneurysm. Like, not like a brain, I know, it's so hard to explain. Like, I don't have a brain aneurysm. That's how severe it is. And he was like, how do you deal with this? Like, this is severe. This is like double the pain, triple the pain of anybody with irregular migraines. And migraines in itself are really painful. I still have the sheets from when I was 14 of him giving me what kind of factors to look out for migraines. And he has circled the one that causes my migraines, which is, this is back in 2004, by the way, lights. And he also wrote here, anti-glare, so I can't have any glares on me in the morning. In the future, I could be high risk for a brain aneurysm. That's the sheet just like explaining it. And then this is my log, and I basically have to write on a scale of 1 to 5 how bad they were, and on the back, like, describe them and when they've happened. So yeah, they're basically all in the morning, 9 a.m., 8:45 a.m., 8:30 a.m., 9:15 a.m., 10:40 a.m., 6:30 p.m., so there is a night one, and 1:20 a.m. Those aren't all my migraines, those are just the only ones that I remember to write down. And these go far back as on the sheet from 2004. To this day, my migraines consist of, I will get a blind spot, but the blind spot is nowhere near that little ball that I was telling you guys about earlier. It now takes up my whole eye and partially my second eye. So I can basically see a little bit out of this eye, like a little bit, and a good portion out of this eye. But I'm basically legally blind when I have my migraine. And at that point, whenever I start seeing the blind spot, I have to go home. I know that I have to go home that instant, no matter where I am, no matter what I'm doing. It's life-threatening. I need to be lying down my head and trying to rest because it can be serious if I'm stressing my brain anymore. It is really scary. So then when I have that, again, it usually lasts for about 15-20 minutes, and then it goes away for about another 15-20 minutes, and then I don't have any pain. But I have double vision in that time now. Before it would be nothing, now I have like severe double vision. Like, I'll be looking at my hand, and I have 21/20 vision, so I'm above average on my vision. My vision is peachy keen jelly bean. So I have double vision when I'm having this. So like, I'll look at my hand and I'll see like two hands. It's very severe. I get really tense right here in my shoulders, all down my back. My whole head is like somebody like cut open my brain and then keeps cutting it on the same place, and somebody at the same time is ripping it open as that guy is cutting it. A knife that has been soaked in hot acid. And once the double vision goes away, then I get the severe headache, and this headache is something I would never wish on my worst enemy. I wouldn't wish these for anybody. These are so bad. Like, they are excruciating. I don't know, I can't explain it anymore, but I think you guys now get the picture. But and then I basically am dead. I basically I'm dead. And the doctor has told me that, you know, be very careful, you have to rest your head, try not to be stressed. We found out what causes it though. In the morning, when I was like 12, 13, my mom would in the morning say, good morning, and turn on the light, right? And, or, you know, she wouldn't turn on the light and I would just go to the bathroom in the morning and just turn on the light. That's what causes my migraines. Bright lights in the morning, just as he circled here, how he could tell that is what causes it. Bright lights right in the morning. So if I turn on the light right away in the light, I know that I will be getting a migraine in about an hour or later that day. I was lucky in my old house where I had a window, but we could have blinds on it. I have skylights, so it's kind of rare to find blinds for it because it's on like an angle, right? It's hard to find blinds for them. I know there is like stickers you can put on there to block the light out, but I haven't found any. My city sucks. Basically, our option right now is towels. And I know that sounds really like ghetto and oh my god, you can put towels on your windows. But would I rather have a severe life-threatening illness or have towels on my windows? Yeah, I would much prefer the towels on my windows. You could make fun of me all you like for having towels on my windows. And some people are like, oh, you're so grubby. Like, maybe you should know the story before you judge. Like, I hate when people judge and make judgment towards that because it's actually a really life, it can be a really life-threatening thing for me if I have the bright lights in the morning. So that's why the towels on my windows, to keep out the light in the morning. And during the day, you know, I can have light. I have to be awake. Wake up, I just have to kind of lie in my bed and get my eyes adjusted to the light around me for about 20 minutes. So that is basically the story. I'm sorry that it took so long, but it really is, has been a long and grueling part of my life. Good part of this story, I know it's all been bad, but a good part of the story is that now that I know what causes my migraines, bright lights in the morning, I've taken the proper precautions of putting the towels up and slowly backing into the light that I rarely get them anymore, just because I know what causes them, so I know how to prevent it. So I haven't had a migraine for about a year and a half. That's such a long time, but I'm so thankful for that because they get worse and worse as the migraines go on. So the next time it's going to be worse than my last one and so on. And I don't know how much more my brain can take, but you know, I'm good now, right? It's just a chance of whether or not I'm going to get one next. When am I going to get one next? I could get one right after this video. I could get one tomorrow. I could get one in a year. I could never get one again. I know that's not going to happen, but because of the towels over the windows, everyone had so many questions. So I hope that triggered your interest in some way or some insight to my life or anything like that. So I want to thank you guys for watching. If you guys want me to do more of these video diary series, then let me know. I have tons of stories in my life. This was kind of a sad one, but it's good now, so at least it's a sad story turned good. Thank you for watching. Thanks for requesting this. Let me know if you want to see more. Bye, guys.